though, last night was.
In an effort to boost a slumping economy, the feds have dropped interest rates to near zero. So what does this mean for consumers? Here this morning is Randy Cordy with Franklin Loan Centers to help us understand. On the surface, this sounds wonderful. It's like almost free money.
Yes, that does sound good on the surface.
Yeah.
I think what most people don't realize, though, is the Fed rate is the rate that banks lend money back and forth to each other. So it doesn't necessarily mean your mortgage rate's going to be now zero or your credit cards are going to now be zero.
But will it mean that consumers will get a break because it's costing less to borrow money?
So a few weeks ago, the rates did drop, and there was a huge rush of business on mortgages, people trying to refinance, that kind of thing. And so, in fact, there was so much business that it was creating a supply and demand issue with money. And so what we did is, what banks across the country did, is rates spiked, they went up. And so what the Fed did in reaction to that was an attempt to ease that. It's called quantitative easing. So what they're actually doing is trying to free up money for banks so that they can continue to lend it without rates going like this.
Okay, because that's really, in these tough times, it's really going to keep things moving along.
That's
with,
right.
With a lower rate. And so people should not be surprised if they say, well, now's a chance to really, you know, take advantage of something like this, and they come to you or another lender and say, you know, I want to refi, and expecting that
right.
The rate is going to be, you know, 1%.
Yeah, it's a question of being prudent versus being greedy, right? So you just have to take a breath. We have a saying at Franklin Loan Center for 2020, it's marathon pace. And so right now it's about just being calm, continue to plod ahead, and just stay on point, stay on focus.
You know, some credit cards have huge interest rates. They do, and they're ridiculous, you know, some double digit. And so will this in some way, will they reflect a lower rate at some point? Because the credit card companies think, well, you know, in these tough times, maybe we can help people out. I know that's, you know, pie in the sky, but
is it a possibility? I'd say it remains to be seen what those kind of institutions will do.
Yeah. And so for people who, you know, hear this, you know, constant drumbeat of lower rates, it really in some ways, you know, will affect them in a very kind of nebulous way.
Well, yes, in some regard, but on the other hand, depending on where you are currently, you need to take a look at it. So honestly, it's a good time to have a good relationship with a mortgage banker, because they're going to help watch your back. They're going to help you plan with your family, with your household, so that you can make sure that you're set up for success as the market does tend to fluctuate, so that you can take advantage at the right time to refinance if it makes sense to do it.
So when you decide, you know, that if you wanted a refi, locking in a loan rate,
yeah,
how long is that good for?
Well, the answer is it depends. So you can...
Everything depends.
No, you can lock in a rate for sometimes it's 30 days on a refinance. Maybe typically right now it's 45 days because there's so much business that it actually does take a little bit more time to complete the loan process.
And it's going to take longer now, right?
Well, it may be right now a little bit. Honestly, like, we have everybody working overtime 24/7. They're working on Saturdays. Underwriters are working on Sundays. I haven't stopped working. It's an incredible time right now.
Yeah, and the other thing is, you know, if they expect, you know, a really low rate because the feds have cut it,
right,
there are closing costs. There's all these other ancillary things that go along, especially with a refi.
That's correct, and that's why you need that relationship I was speaking to, because you want to see what the savings are versus, okay, how long is it going to take to recoup those savings based on the cost of doing the loan. I mean, some people consider, you know, equity is just free money, but equity is equity, and it's real, and it's yours, and it should be respected.
All right. Well, we'll see how long this goes on for.
Yeah.
All right. Randy, thanks for being
with
us this morning.
Here.
Yeah, appreciate it. All right. Get some rest.
Yeah.
We'll take a break.